That'd be so wonderful. iCarly was the best show of 2006. No, so, no comments.
Dislikes.
No
dislikes.
Comments.
Switches off video.
You know what's, you know what I also find funny? I get annoyed every time I have to introduce myself into a new video. Like, I mean, today's a lazy day, but whatever. Well, I'll just do it for one.
Eventually, we'll make so many that we don't have to.
True, true. Anyways, you get the deal. It's the same cybernetic trio, Mr. Best Buy employee that got fired, and Octopus Man, who apparently doesn't like anime.
You made me Godzilla.
Oh, but no, but like your name on your freaking thing though.
Yeah, I know, but I remember when you made the intro last time.
Oh, that's it, cause it was part of the joke. I don't know. You want to be Godzilla still?
Sure. I mean, your name on thing is not Best Buy employee. It's Aerovation. So I mean,
I know, but like I like just doing that every time we have a video together or something. That's...
Hello, I was Godzilla.
I was really Godzilla.
Like, really calf size.
Calf size? You were the bite size?
I was discount gods.
Discount gods. Oh, man. Crazy. Anyways, you already know what we're doing today. Today we're going to be reviewing a video. No, not a video. A movie that has been in hype for about a really long time now. Today we're going to be talking about Inception 2. I mean, all in all, like the effects they had in that movie looks exactly the same as Inception, but like freaking they can control what goes on. It's like, yo, it's the same city too, I think. I don't know.
I love how we go straight into effects, just like no segue.
I no. mean, like that's the first thing I wanted to say. That the whole movie, it looks like a freaking Inception sequel, but with a bunch of nerds who wear like funny cloaks.
Yes. However, there are plenty of visually stunning scenes in this movie.
I know there is. I like the graphics. I wasn't downing it. I was just saying.
You just call them graphics? Don't be one of those fucking people who's like, I love the graphics.
I love the graphics. I know it's special effects. Yeah, but I'm so used to like video games. I'm so used to video games that like I just base it off of the fact that it's a video game. So I'm just like, okay, yeah, it's a video game. Graphics, best graphics.
The Elder Scrolls 6, Doctor Strange.
Anyways, yeah, we're getting a little off topic, but other than that, let's just get straight into the movie. This movie is a very.
Now, the first thing I want to say...
Oh, you want to go? Go ahead.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so we start off, and I love this scene. I love how it starts, because it starts off, and basically Dr. Strange is, like, doing surgery on a guy, and he's, like, doing a little dance while he's doing it, right? Now, this is amazing, because I know, I've heard people say, like, oh, that's, like, that's more Marvel cheese. They're being unrealistic.
Marvel cheese.
Here's the thing, right?
What?
We all want to believe that's unrealistic, but what I've heard from, like, doctors who do surgery, they do all sorts of things when you're asleep on that bed.
Oh, really?
Some of them, like, yeah, some of them are, like, very serious. Like, a lot of them are very serious, but some of them, they do fuck around a lot.
Yeah, because, like, if you're in there for, like, a whole, like, 24 hours, then what are you supposed to do? Like, if you have, like, a chip... As long as you know what you're doing, like...
The ones who are really good at their jobs.
Yeah.
But
it's the same. It's the same cliche of newbies are too scared to fuck up, so they don't do anything.
Yeah. No. I have heard stories of some. I don't know. Maybe they're the bad.
What about the hammer? The hammer thing from like I saw in the dank meme video. Like you just see him like hammer. At some, use a hammer during a surgery. I'm like, what the fuck?
Okay. Well, anyway, we are here today to review Doctor Strange, the latest Marvel movie, and another one in a what has been a winning streak for them, really.
Yeah, this is probably one of the best movies I've seen for them in a while.
Like, to be honest. since Captain America: Winter Soldier, I don't think there's been any lackluster ones. Like, after Thor: The Dark World, they've all been like really good. Even Thor: The Dark World was just like kind of okay.
Yeah, I actually haven't seen that one yet. That's the only one I haven't seen yet.
You can skip it unless they pull something in Infinity War. with the Infinity Stones, right? Like, one shows like it's kind of big because one shows up in it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how much though. When they do come together, will they actually tie into the movies, or maybe they'll give you some exposition beforehand so you're all right? But all right. I mean, I wouldn't recommend. I wouldn't necessarily say you have to watch it.
Whatever. If it's I'm more focused on like anything from then, because for the past year I've been like slacking when it comes to movies because of freaking college. So.
Same, and I just think for me, I remember like back in 2014, I would see a new movie like every week. I went to see what the next newest biggest thing was. 2015, less so. In 2016, now I usually just kind of see every once in a while, which I shouldn't. I think as someone who likes movies, and especially one who helping to make films and stuff, you should watch a lot of films. Anyway,
that's the point of what we're doing, but yeah, I should, yeah. Now that I have more like access, then I should be able to do more movies, but yeah. So
anyway, we are here to talk about Doctor Strange, and this was hell of a fun time. I saw it twice in theaters.
You saw it twice?
Yeah.
Like, jeez.
I see any movie I like, I usually see around 3 times, but I saw this one. It's been a while since I've done that, so I saw this one twice.
I've only seen one movie twice, and I think it was way back in like 2012.
I saw the first movie I ever saw like multiple times in theaters was 2014's Godzilla. I saw that 3 times.
Jeez.
I saw Star Wars Episode 7 3 times in theaters. I saw Jurassic World 3 times in theaters.
Okay, settle down there.
I think that's it. I'm trying to think. Did I see anything else multiple times? I don't think so. I would have saw Civil War, but it was when that came out. It was right when I was ending, it was ending, you know, high school, and there were a bunch of stuff happening around that time, right? So.
All right. Whatever. That's yeah. Your choice. Me personally, I would like see it once, only because, you know, I'm too cheap for that, but whatever floats your boat, you know? If a movie's like really good, then I'll watch it more than once, but that's how I do. In fact, there are people who don't even watch the movie once in theaters. They usually go use Put Locker because they're too cheap for that.
But nothing be like people are like, why are you paying $15 for a movie? It's like it's not just to see the movie, right? But I just want to see a movie, but I really
can't. I want to see a movie, but I want to see it in like full quality.
Yeah, but also I could wait till Netflix and watch it on TV, or you know, buy it on Blu-ray or something. But like there's certain movies that I go to the theaters because I want that theater experience. I want the big screen. I love full crowds. At least the first time I see something. Mm-hmm. I love seeing a full crowd.
Yeah. It's better with other people than by yourself. Especially. Yeah.
Unless, like, sometimes kids annoy me. And I'm not one of those fucking edgelords like, I fucking hate kids. It's like, no, I'm just trying to pay attention to the movie. And I'm one of those people who I gravitate towards, like, different, like, when people talk and stuff. So since kids talk a lot, I can't help but like be distracted by them, basically.
Yeah.
It's nothing to do with them, it's me.
Dude, you're getting off topic again. Whatever, I don't even care. Let's get on with the topics. Okay, for Doctor Strange, I have a couple topics I want to talk about. If you want to talk about something else, go ahead. But
What's your first topic?
The first topic is how salty he is. About how, like... Okay, go.
I love that about him in the beginning. He is, here's the thing, there are a lot of movies where they'll say a like, you'll have other characters say, like, oh, this guy is like this and like this, but then they're not really like that. In this movie, the characters always say how arrogant Doctor Strange is, but it works because he really is arrogant as fuck. Like, he is so full of himself, and he is kind of cold, really. One of my favorite scenes in the movie is near the beginning, where it's when he tells his girlfriend off, and I loved it because the reaction from the audience was great. They all sighed because what happened is his girlfriend. He made an argument, and then out of nowhere, he just goes, she's like, this is the point where you say sorry, and then he's like, this is the point where you get out. Like, oh shit,
savage.
It's a pretty intense, like, I really just love that scene, because, like, the audience reacted perfectly. They were just, like I said, after that, they're like,
oh wow.
And this was, what, the first 20, like, just for 15 minutes, we're already invested.
Well, that whole scene, like, with the cliche thing, I wouldn't, like, put so much emphasis on it. It was like...
That's just because I see that cliche all the time, and I...
I know, but I empathize with it. Like, I emphasize with him. That's why I see it, like, oh, that's gonna happen. Like, he's not gonna actually say sorry, because...
They always say sorry. That's what I mean, right?
Well, what if they say sorry and they don't mean it? They just
that's what I mean. It's bright, like, it's a cliche in movies, in other movies.
I guess it really depends
on
what the people.
And also, I think I realize it too, because usually when people react, usually the audience at Marvel movies, they usually laugh at the jokes, but they're usually quiet during the, like, kind of the more emotional scenes. This was the first time I've ever been to a Marvel movie, and there have been Marvel movies with emotional scenes, like, plenty in Civil War. But in this one, this is the first time I've ever seen the audience, like collectively react to something like this. That's why it sticks out for me, but I see so many movies, right? So that's probably why, too. Or at least I see almost most of these Marvel movies that come out. I see the DC movies, too. It's funny, I don't really like them, but I want to be fair to them.
Mm-hmm.
So I go see them as well in theaters.
Yeah, yeah. Other than that, there's also the fact that, like, he always, like, picks on Doctor Strange. I like that part of the movie, because
picks on Doctor Strange?
No, he nitpicks on his name, as in, you know how, like, every time someone calls him Mr. Strange, he's like, Doctor Strange, you know?
Yeah, like, he takes, like, you see the pride there. He takes pride in the title of Doctor.
I know, I don't know why, but I just like that, the fact that he keeps doing that.
Yeah, I know, because it matches his character. This is an arrogant bastard, this guy. He really is. But he's still, you could tell that, like, when he becomes, like, you know, humble and good, it's not a surprise. You totally buy it. Mm-hmm. You tell this guy he is a person still.
Yeah.
He's just an arrogant person, but he's not, like... Like, usually arrogant characters, always cliche, but he's not.
Mm-hmm.
And it's good, too, that he's more so arrogant than, like, say, Iron Man is, Tony Stark. Because he could have been a Tony Stark clone way too easily, but I like how they...
I know.
They were able to, like, not do that by really pushing... How much of an arrogant, like, that's
how like self pride, yeah.
That's the thing where Tony Stark was more, he was full of himself, but he was more comedic too. This guy, I think that helps that he was he made jokes, but he was way less comedic than Tony Stark. His arrogance was clearly, like, more so from his idea that he could do anything. This comes up again when he's the scene where he's with the doctor, and the doctor tells him off, and then at the end he's like, "This will ruin me if I do it," and you kind of get the idea like that's why this is a thing in the community, I guess, in this movie. Like, I don't know how true that is in real life.
Mm-hmm. Real life? What do you mean?
IRL?
I know, but like.
I don't know if doctors will actually just flat out like deny a patient just for the sake of reputation. I doubt it.
I doubt it too. Even if they deny them, someone else will take their thing. They can't just freaking throw someone out. It's like, bruh.
Yeah, I think someone who doesn't have a reputation will be willing to take. And I think like even if they're like, you're the only one who can do it, I don't think so. I think most trained doctors would at least try. They wouldn't just say, I can't do it, and the guy who's good enough to won't do it. It's like, we're getting into like conspiracy
bullshit.
Like
doctor
politics. Like, I don't know anything about that.
I know. Like, I know what you mean. It kinda seems, that's one thing that kinda seems unrealistic to like deny. I mean, it should be his responsibility to do it. It shouldn't be a choice.
Yeah.
Because he could have done something different.
On one hand, he's a doctor, and he's a surgeon, but, like, I don't know how exactly, because apparently he's not, like, a full-time thing, because he does presentations or something, they said. So maybe, and we have to remember, too, it's in America. I don't know how they're like. We talk about, we live in Canada. All we know is that like we have the free healthcare. They don't. But I don't know the details. You know.
Yeah, yeah. Ours is more simple. Theirs is more like they have all these different plans and stuff because they want to. They don't want to like make it absolutely free. They want to at least make money out of it. So it's.
I mean, I don't know. Like I said, I don't know the details. I believe. I know a lot of people like, our one's better, or like, Canada's better, or USA's better, and the other one's just trash. Statistically speaking, I think both are good in comparison to the rest of the world.
Well, from a long shot, yeah.
So, I mean, heck, if I get sick, I'm not scared I'm gonna fucking die.
I know, because, like, you don't have think everything you need.
Yeah. Well, that's from... maybe someone else is not in that position. This has gone way downhill. Like,
let's just say we'll leave this for another time because this is something going way into like this is going into the healthcare system, and like
our comments are doomed if this video ever gets more than like a couple if this video ever does well for whatever reason.
No, like in a nutshell, if this channel ever does well, everything we say will be taken against us in the future. That's why I stay open. I don't like.
Here's the problem: staying open could get you lynched now on YouTube. Like, no matter it doesn't. Here's the thing. Here's the laws of the YouTube opinion.
Laws of Aaron, YouTube opinion.
Do you think?
It's like, do you think or do you know?
No. Aaron, do you think yes or no?
Do I think? Everyone thinks.
You're wrong.
It's like, I have an opinion triggered.
Triggered.
Anyways, yeah, we'll leave that for another time, but... the idea should stay open, I guess. I don't know. I guess we'll look into it ourselves. But yeah. Anyways, other than the doctor thing, I guess we should move on to the next topic, which I have here today, which is something that I know you don't want to talk about, but I'm gonna talk about it anyway because.
Oh no.
Okay, as a car guy, the scene where he brings out his Lamborghini, that triggered me so freaking hard. Like, how, like, if you look at the specifics of the scene, he drives perfectly in the mountains, almost swoops through the cars, blah blah blah. He gets the phone, texting like this. He can clearly, he puts it down seconds before the truck comes. He has time to get out of the way, yet he keeps going in the opposite direction, spins out, and then fucks himself over, and then somehow survives, and the freaking car is wrecked. Oh my god.
It's called superhero movie.
It's called freaking Paul, like, it's called What Should Have Happened to Paul Walker. That's what it's fucking called.
Aaron, this is a movie where if you stick out one hand and put the other hand in circular motions, you can teleport.
Teleport. Oh yeah, those little things that people pick out. I know what you mean. Yeah.
Like, okay, here's the thing. Like, I get, just because it's a superhero comic, does it protect it from all, like, complaints about plot holes? But that one is just so, like,
it's funny though, because it's funny. It's funny though when people, like, they nitpick on it. It's like, it's funny that they didn't see it, because once you think about it, it seems stupid that they didn't. Yeah. But it only appeared for like a minute, so it doesn't really do anything to the movie. We just know that he had a Lambo and he. Another joke.
If you're the. Oh, okay.
It's just like, here in my garage, just bought this new Lamborghini here. Then you see a news story that says, Ty Lopez just crashed his new Lamborghini. Guess who crashed it? Doctor Strange.
Oh, okay.
I don't know, I'm just. The fact that he has a Lamborghini, just like, oh, he must have lots of knowledge.
Oh, I got it. Doctor Strange is like, here in my garage, my Lamborghini, and he's pointing at it, and his hands are shaky.
And his hands are shaky? Oh my god, that'd be funny. Alright.
I feel like that's offensive to someone.
It probably is, but
if
like.
If they have shaky hands, can they type?
Can they type? Oh, savage. I mean, they could, but they can't feel it.
I just majorly triggered someone out there.
Mm-hmm. Alright, what were you saying before? When I was.
What I was saying was, like, that just seems such a red. Like, because to me, it just seemed like he's texting and he crashed.
Yeah.
They tell you don't text and drive. Because that's.
and he denies it. Oh my god. Like.
Don't text and drive or else you get superpowers.
I can get over it. But that scene is the entire reason everything happened in the movie. It's so freaking funny how one little, mistake.
You know what's funny? Because they probably digitally added in the light effect that showed the truck coming towards them, right?
Mm-hmm.
So everything, like, what all you're saying, it's probably just a matter of timing. If they just put in that effect a few seconds earlier, then it would have made, like, total sense. Even if, like, I don't know, maybe, I'm sure that's happened to someone where. Well, you have to remember, too, right? In the moment of, like, you see that truck facing you, and this is what people don't understand. When your flight or when your fight or flight reflexes kick in, there's no guarantee of what's going to happen, because you don't control yourself anymore, basically, right?
Yeah.
And it's such a, like, yeah. Like, to us, it's like, oh yeah, he had time. But imagine, like, that slight moment. Also, there's a moment of shock, too. The second he saw that thing coming in, there would have been that moment of fear that he, like, and, like, his kind of first reaction to it. And in that moment of fear is enough time, obviously, for the truck to hit him.
Yeah. I won't let it get too much into it, but basically, if you think about it, That's like a really good key point of the plot, because they have to find a way to get, like, oh, so these the guys in the office are thinking, oh, how are we gonna trigger situation in which he's gonna get superpowers. Oh, we'll make him crash a car with a stupid mistake that could be avoided.
Okay. I feel like, oh yeah, you should name this the Doctor Strange podcast, like, not the dark, because this is not really a review.
I know it's not a review, because, like, I don't know that much about the series of Doctor Strange.
I know, but, like, well,
so I can't go,
you talk about characters, you talk about visuals, which is, I know picking apart pieces of the movie.
I know it's a podcast, I know. But,
so at this point, yeah, it's a podcast. So, like, if you want, like, if you want a detailed review, this is not it. Like probably in the future, what I'm gonna do with Rahul is that we're probably gonna go through, we're gonna review, like, all the Marvel movies
as a whole, like, as a whole, or like one by
oh
one
no
by...
like one by one for Iron Man,
damn, Incredible. Okay,
nice. I mean, one day we're gonna do a Godzilla-thon. That's all 30
shit. Okay,
it's like 31, because we're including the 98 one. I know some people don't, but it's like, might as well.
Oh, I think I've watched... I recently watched that one again.
It's pretty bad.
I know.
It's not even like, oh, it goes against the design. Oh, he's not really Godzilla. Like, that doesn't matter. The movie itself just sucks.
Yeah, yeah.
It has a generic story, generic characters, generic action sequences. Everything. Just generic.
Yeah. Anyways, well, you know about that, but, like, before you continue, I wanna, like, really wanna nitpick on this next character.
Okay.
So, okay, yeah, you guys know, freaking reviews coming soon. Okay, good. So, apparently I just found out the girl's name, the Holy One, as they call her.
The Ancient One.
The Ancient One.
You're nitpicking on the Ancient One? I really like the Ancient One in those.
I know, but, like, wait, I know, I liked her, but, like, throughout the movie, I was just, like, confused as to either she was really the hero or the villain
what
of the movie.
Character? No.
You know?
No, I didn't bring it. Yeah.
So I'm gonna start, I started recording. So, I just found out her name was, Tilda Swinton. I didn't know that throughout the movie, but I looked online, that's her full name. Now, if she has a full name, I'm guessing that means she was human at one point, and then she just used, like, the powers of her powers to keep her, like, alive all these years. But that's basically about her. Like, I thought, like, when I first watched the movie, I thought she was just called the Asian One or whatever, because I don't, like, cause, like, I thought she was like the, like, a god or something of the realm or whatever. Then I found out, like, and then everyone finds out that, oh, she's not really a god, she's just a human being that's been, like, using power, other, feeding off of the, of a, whatever, what's the core called?
The dark dimension.
Yeah, she's feeding off the dark dimension to stay alive all these years, and that's basically what happened. So I was just like, oh, cause, like, during the movie, I didn't really get what was going on, but at the end, when they started, like, revealing what she was really doing, I was like, oh, well, like, but I was still thinking to myself.
They believed that she was this, like, deity, like, that she was this almost deity-esque character, was Aegis, but because she was that's what I said, by the way. We're gonna get to that character soon.
I know. But before we, like, talk about the end, like, we'll just leave that off to the end, but, like, I really want to catch up on the ending, because I'm really glad I stayed in the theater till the end, because that scene, I saw it coming. Like,
he's a villain in the comics.
I know. I saw it coming.
From what I know. I yeah.
So I already knew he was gonna be the villain, but it's just, like, funny.
What? Really? What?
I found the ending funny because
no.
Like...
Sorry. I was just looking up like just information on Doctor Strange, right?
Yes.
And apparently, from what I'm getting at, Doctor Strange, Cumberbatch, it says here, also plays Dormammu.
Like, oh, so he was talking to himself?
Because he's done stuff like this. He's done stuff like this before. Apparently, he did the motion capture. He did it, and like someone else did it too, and they combined the voices.
Mm-hmm. Oh, did they like this like? Did they just like edit his voice really, really well so that like, oh, you couldn't tell, right?
Yeah, I mean, he didn't have to. I mean, like, it's kind of like with Smaug in the Hobbit movies. Smaug. You could have, like, here's the thing, right? Like, you could have had someone just go up there and, you know, say these lines and just snarl a lot.
Yeah.
And it would have been the same.
Like,
but.
I think that's kind of true. Like you're getting into something new because I haven't because I didn't know that. So I'm just, but it doesn't really matter. Really, we just know that like we.
Mordo. That's the sidekick's name. Mordo.
That's a weird name. Is that his real name? Are you sure? Like his
character's name is Carl Mordo, and they refer to him by his last name. His real name is I can't say this. Chiwetel Ejiofor.
Okay. From that name, I can tell he probably came to the place from Africa or something, because that's an African name. Or he came from England, according to his accent. I know the whole African English accent. That's what it sounds like to me.
Yeah, definitely. He was probably. But the thing is, if his parents like. They moved here, and he was. And maybe gave him a.
Maybe we'll learn more about it in the next movie because.
I'm just talking about the actor. Like maybe his parents came over. They could have given him a Western name or, with names. You never know.
I know. I don't really nitpick on names because like I just wait for the story to tell itself.
I'm talking about the actor, not the character.
Both. I'm talking about both.
Oh okay. Oh yeah. Also speaking of names, Wong plays Wong.
In what? Oh, in the movie?
The guy who was Wong. His name is Benedict Wong.
In real life?
Yeah.
Benedict. There's two Benedicts.
Because I'm like, how funny would it be if the guy's... Like, literally, I was just like, how funny would it be if the guy's real name was Wong? And I saw the end credits, and... That's Benedict Wong.
There you go. I'm gonna input that scene when I edit.
So I guess we're just going through the characters right now. So
yeah.
So there's Wong, and Wong was great. I liked him a lot as a kind of a pseudo comedic relief character. Although he's more of just like kind of a punchline for Doctor Strange to just like kind of screw around with.
Yeah, that makes sense.
But like he's definitely like. You definitely feel there's a strength there, like, because he's talking, and yeah, he's giving these threats, and you sort of believe him almost, just by the way he looks and stuff. Like, this guy is, he does not fuck around whatsoever.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of, and then, but then it kind of would make sense that, like, when Doctor Strange, he names these, like, kind of pop... He keeps naming these pop artists to him. And it kind of makes sense that he would go look them up just because it would make him curious. Like, why, like, who the fuck are these people, you know?
Mm-hmm. That makes sense. Mm-hmm. All right, so did he have much scenes in the movie? I think he appeared, like, for a good 20 minutes, maybe?
You see him first time Doctor Strange goes to the library. You see him when Doctor Strange steals some books in a pretty funny scene.
Yep.
You see him when Doctor Strange learns to use
the time.
Yeah. Which is, no spoiler, like, I think everyone knows by now, it holds one of the Infinity Stones.
Oh, it does?
Yeah, at the end, they're like,
quick question. How much Infinity Stones are there in total?
I think there's five. I'm gonna see. Infinity Stones. There are six.
Oh. There's six. I have to freaking find all four, five, and six of them now.
Hold up. I'm online right now. I'm gonna go. I'm gonna find. Just like an interview or something. I'm gonna see how much we have. Okay, so there's the Tesseract, the Space Stone, mm-hmm. and that was in the Avengers. Mm-hmm. The Aether, the Reality Stone, is in Thor: The Dark World. That's what I was talking about. It's like a liquid sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
The Power Stone, which they call the Orb. I just realized the names. The Orb from Guardians of the Galaxy, that's the Power Stone.
Mm-hmm.
The Stone in Vision is the Mind Stone. The Time Stone was in Doctor Strange. Mm-hmm. And then there's the Soul Stone. Okay, this wasn't the greatest sight. Let me find it. It's pretty garbage. It was just an interview with the guy who did it. I don't think he's really knows what he's talking about too much. So that was a time, because at the end of the movie, didn't you hear, he's like, you shouldn't mess with an Infinity Stone.
I know he talked about the Infinity Stones, but I'm like, I didn't know where it was. I didn't know it was in the time, in that time thing.
Hmm.
I thought, like, oh wait, but you that know, would make sense, because that you know necklace was the only artifact.
You know what's funny? I was, when I saw Age of Ultron, that's when they show Thor's vision building up to the Infinity Gauntlet stuff, right?
Mm-hmm.
And what's pretty funny is that when that scene, I've only seen the movie, I think, in full once. Mm-hmm. And for no particular reason, I just never got around to seeing it again. But I went to the washroom as that scene happened and finished.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I left the theater, that scene happened, I come back, and I ask my friends, like, what did I miss? And he's just like, you just missed something big.
Mm-hmm. Go into more detail into the ones. Because I'm kind of confused as to what you just said, to be honest.
Oh, in Avengers Age of Ultron, basically Thor has a vision of, like, he has of the, you know, Thanos getting the Infinity Stones and destroying everything, right?
Yep.
And I missed that scene entirely, and that's basically the premise of, like, that's where Avengers is leading up to, this guy getting all the Infinity Stones. The stones go in a gauntlet, and the gauntlet can destroy everything. I don't know comic books. This is what I read off of wikis and talked to friends. Like, I have, like, friends told me about this who have read comics and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Back now, to Dr. Strange.
Now, moving on. I like that little touch they had when he was like, oh, did they just go on an LSD trip or something? Because if he had not said that, I would have talked about it. But, like, the fact that he brought it up, it was like, it was a good, like, I just, it was so funny. Because, like,
Wait, what did he bring up?
Don't worry, it'll show up in my recording. But, basically, what I was talking about was how he was talking about being in an LSD trip, because that's basically what happens.
Same thing. Like, what did you put in my tea?
It's like, oh, you'll know. I was like, that was funny, because I'm like, when I saw that scene go down, I was like, I couldn't follow what was going on. Like, it kept changing, ever changing every 5 seconds. I'm like, what the heck?
And the visuals were incredible. This is a case where, like, they use CG to make something that, yeah, I don't, maybe you could do with practical effects, but I think if you did it with practical effects, it wouldn't look as good in practical effects.
Yeah, yeah.
Than what they did here. Because I'm sure there's been, like, weird dream sequences, stuff like this. And I think that's the real strength of this movie. It recognizes, like, we could do so much with CGI, and let's just go full force with it.
Yeah, true.
Like, a lot of movies where you're like, you know, they didn't really need to use.
Like, this, it depends on the movie. Some movies don't need to use it, some movies do. And it really depends on the content of the, I'm guessing, the characters, like, the how much character they bring. If they don't bring enough character, they should bring enough effects to go along with it, I guess.
Well, then you got movies that are, like, all effect and no
character. All effect and no character, yeah.
We could discuss Transformers failing all
Transformer. Day. Oh, that would trigger Furcon for sure.
Yeah, but everyone else, like, just joined in the internet circle jerk, you know. I know movies because I say Transformers sucks. And I don't like Transformers, but, like, I feel like there's a lot of people who are just, they say it sucks, but, like, they probably just, like, they, if it wasn't for the fact that the internet hated it, they would have, like, forgotten they've seen it.
Yeah, I only like the first ones. I only like the first two, I think.
The first two? Because two is the most hated. Two is the one the Transformers fans don't like.
I know it is, because it doesn't go through the story. I know, but, like,
no, because there's so many things.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, and it has those, like, titanium, like, what are those things called? The huge destroyer, the wrecking balls, right?
Wrecking balls.
So they form in between his legs, and just, like, really? And he has, like, 2 minutes of screen time, then he's gone.
He's gone. Meh. They could have done, like, I wouldn't want to go remember the whole movie, because I don't really, I haven't watched that in a while, but
I don't want to watch that again.
I know. Like, the new movie, like, personally, I'm done with Transformers, so I don't, like, the new movie that they're coming out, I'm just like, eh, whatever. They had a chance, they ruined it, whatever. But yeah, that's one thing.
Back to good movies.
Like, back to good movies like Doctor Strange. Okay, so, I saw one joke on the internet, and, like, it was so funny, I had to bring it up again. Remember when you're talking about Dormammu, I've come to bargain?
Yeah.
It shows, like, Hillary Clinton's face.
Oh, fucking
so, God. Like, I was thinking of a parody where he's, like, where, Dormammu is Donald Trump, and, Doctor Strange is Hillary Clinton, and she's asking him to bargain, and then he just wrecks her. That'd be funny.
Do you like now the comments are gonna be even worse than what I made fun of people with disabilities.
Dude, like, I'm not trying to get political.
No one's gonna see this video.
I know it isn't
200 views. I hope we don't get over it. I hope this video fails, honestly.
I know. Actually,
the comment sections are gonna be so cancer. If imagine if we were, like, big YouTubers.
If we got big, then we wouldn't be able to save shit. That's why I'm so, like, open.
I think it's just, I have delusions of grandeur. I'm like, maybe this video will do well.
And maybe it won't, whatever. Like, I remember that I had this one video way back that I thought was gonna do shit, and it's like my best video on my channel, and it's like, the quality of the video is so bad and I hate it, but it has so much views and so much likes, and I'm like, why do people go to this video and click it?
Do you see what trends on YouTube?
I know. It's so bad, but why is it so, like, why is it getting so much views?
You ever seen those terrifying toy channels?
And Ethan Bradbury, freaking Spider-Man.
Spider-Man and Elsa video.
Oh man, that was funny.
I've never watched one. I've only seen the clips that H3
yeah, will show, same.
And they terrify me.
I know they do. Out,
the music's disturbing. The video gives off a pedophilic vibe almost.
Not even. It gives off like a vibe for like it's made for older audiences.
No, here's the thing, right? It's like, oh, this is clearly kickbait for kids, and I'm thinking, I would never let any of these people near children.
Yeah. Alright, so...
Maybe that's how we get successful.
Clickbait cancer. Honestly.
I mean, even channels that, like, don't want to be clickbait, they're like, the only way you could do well is fucking clickbait, because that's what the YouTube algorithm...
I know.
You know what the YouTube algorithm prefers? Clickbait videos. Videos where you beg for likes at the beginning.
Yeah.
Videos where you yell and scream a lot.
Yep.
It's...
Other than that, I don't think there's much else.
So
I
can here's what nitpick. You gotta do. Like, yeah, just put a thumbnail of, like, ass.
Or no, like, just put, like, how to get pussy real fast. 100% working as of 2016.
Gone sexual.
Gone sexual. Oh my god. Anyways, other than that, I don't think there's anything else I can nitpick about the movie. Like, other than what you said before, it was a really good movie, and, like, it's something that, like, I haven't seen in a long time, and I hope that, like, they keep making, like, really good, like, not only in character-wise, but also graphics-wise. If there's a balance between both of those, that makes a good movie.
I mean, at this point, just name this pod, like, Wolfpack podcast 2.
Doctor Strange.
It's not a, like, put in brackets, Doctor Strange. And like whatever else bullshit we talk about in this video, because it's not a Doctor Strange review
like
anymore.
We just went off topic so hard. We're just like, you know what? He's a doctor. Let's talk about that. Oh look, there's a Lamborghini. Let's talk about that. Oh man.
Oh god. What? I mean, we just went a whole tangent about clickbait.
Because like I know, but, like, I like to nitpick at the significant things in the movie. I don't like to go into every single little detail, you know?
Yeah, but we didn't really, like, we discussed the characters, but we didn't really talk about how they acted and stuff like that, you know?
We did, plot. Kinda, but not
imagine,
all
like,
of them.
Like, I don't think we've even described what the plot is.
It's true.
The plot. Like, we just brought out, like, Dormammu, Mardo, fucking the Ancient One. We named all these names, like, who...
It's like, who are these people? It's just like, I mean,
what's this bargaining you're talking about? Why is Hillary Clinton in this?
True, I have to describe that shit at the beginning. Okay, I'll put a disclaimer. I'll be like, before you watch this video. Anything, basically.
Like Vine, elections.
Elections, Trump, bank meme, YouTube, every single YouTube channel on YouTube, every single frickin'... thing that you could until you get to the freaking tag limit, and you click upload.
Sombra.
Sombra. Gamer shot. Oh my god. I love that joke.
Unboxing 100.
or no, here's a classic. How to stop the train in GTA 5.
Quibble cobblers for years.
Quibble, or like, what's his name? Jelly, or whatever his
name is. I swear, when I saw one Quibble Cop video, and like, I think that's the noise cats make when they die, you know? Like, oh, no, no, Cuddles.
Oh, man. That joke was so funny when he bragged it up in the video. I was like, oh my god. Anyways, that's all I have. Is there anything else that you had that you want to add before I freaking cut this thing off?
So I just want to add, we'll be doing a review of all the Marvel movies.
You already said that.
We'll be doing Godzilla. I'm gonna try to do solo reviews, see how that goes. Mm-hmm. And if it goes well, I'll keep doing them. The problem is, and the reason I do it with you guys, I always find it a bit hard, like awkward talking in front of a camera without any
context. People there, yeah. What you mean.
Without someone to jump off from and stuff. But, I think the problem is too, like, I do them scripted. If I don't do them scripted, I'm worried that I'll forget. Here's the problem.
I know what you mean.
If I do them scripted, I'm worried I'll forget something. But when I do them scripted, when I fuck up, I stop altogether.
I know, because it's so annoying to like keep doing that over and over. I'd rather just like wing it in one go and just blast it into freaking editor and post it. I know what you mean.
Yeah. But we're gonna try to get some, you know, more quality content than whatever you call this.
Quote unquote quality content on YouTube.
hold up. Before we go, let's see what's trending.
What's trending? Hold on. I can use Google Come Trends. Together, Google
directed by Wes Anderson, starring Adrian Brody, H&M. Would you eat this homemade gummy chicken?
What? Gummy chicken?
Try not to laugh or grin. Funny Kids Fail Collection, number 16. And it's a kid holding, like, some sort of fruit to his chest so they look like breasts. It's really odd.
What the fuck?
Okay. Bad kids driving Power Wheels ride on cars. McDonald's drive-through prank. In all caps, don't wake up, daddy. IRL challenge. Family fun games for kids. Egg surprise. War at Extreme Supercade.
That's the thing about freaking what's trending nowadays. It's just the same type of videos. And people are just making so much money off of it. Oh my god. What is that? I just saw the gummy chicken.
Here's one of those Elsa and the Spider-Man ones with like three other characters.
What the heck is the Vietnam notebook? The heck?
Oh, Casey Neistat, he's doing, rather than doing daily vlogs, he's trying to make like kind of these short film sort of things.